Hey, peeps! Or at least the around 1,000 of you that actually watch these War Thunder videos. Hello, I appreciate you greatly. But yes, this is actually, I think this is the first time I've ever done a proper intro for one of these videos. Usually I just hop right into the action, but this is a very entertaining video, at least for me. So I don't have a lot of time today, unfortunately. So I went ahead and cobbled up a little compilation of one of the most entertaining vehicles I've ever played in this game. You see, America has a bunch of interesting tanks. As you can see, I'm about halfway through the tech tree. But yeah, like I said, they have very interesting tanks. We got right here, we got what I like to call the Amazon package. This is about as cuboidal as you can get, I guess, if you're not a tiger tank. Then we also have the, hold on, alien spaceship right here. Because, I mean, like, what? What? This looks like a spaceship. But the pinnacle of American tank design is this, which I just call me and the boys. Because let's go ahead and take this into the test drive real quick. You see, peeps, someone really liked go-karting in the American Army, and they were like, now wait a minute, it's wartime, but I don't want to stop my hobby for playing with my go-karts. So he strapped a gun to his go-kart, and this is a pretty mean mamma jamma, and him and the boys are out here go-karting in war. And yeah, so as you can imagine, a vehicle like this, not very survivable. It's got the engine in the front here, so you know that's nice. If you get shot in the front, the engine might take the shell and your crew might be okay, but everyone's just sitting out in the open, so any tank that has machine guns, which is 99.9% of tanks, of course, except for this one, because like I said, it is a go-kart, can just spray your crew down and kill you, because you only have 3 people. And if 2 of them die, that is just straight up game over. And now I know you're thinking, oh, but they've got this cute little plate here of armor. Now I'm sure you can notice Mr. Broseph over here does not know how to duck and cover because he is just not behind it. And then of course we have the driver with his giant steering wheel sitting behind glass. So, you know, how protective is it really? And the answer is it's not. So what you have to do with this tank is you have to embrace your inner goblin. You have to go goblin mode, because the advantage of this being a go-kart with a gun is that it's very tiny. You can look at this tiny rock just right here, and we're basically hidden entirely behind the rock. No one will be able to see me behind this rock. So you have to play very sneaky. You have to be one with the bushes and sneak up around enemies on flanks and set ambushes like this. Like imagine a panther coming right through here. He has no idea, and then boom, and he's dead. So this tank was a learning process for me, because I tried to play it like a tank and I did horribly. I spent many of my first games with this dying with no kills, and you know, it wasn't fun, and I thought this tank sucked. And then, like I said, I embraced my inner goblin, and now this is one of my favorite tanks in the game. So, yeah, I guess we're gonna hop right into it. Like I said, this video is going to be a little bit rushed, so no commentary. It's just a little fun compilation of all the silly moments we had, but I hope you all enjoyed nonetheless, and thank you all so much for watching. Thank you.
We'll be right back. near.
Most of the strategic zones.
into the map.